All right, so we're going to talk about trap preparation, and specifically we're going to dye and wax these traps to get them ready for setting in the field. But when you buy traps and they're right out of the box, they're coated, the steel is coated with an oily film, just a manufacturer's film that's on the steel, and that's got to come off to be able to, well, number one, for odor, but also to be able to put the trap into a solution and what we call dyeing it, which is, this is a real common product right here. It's logwood trap dye, and it's a powder brown. You just mix this in a pot of hot water and bring it to a boil. And when you simmer your traps in there, they'll take on a really dark color, dark brown to almost black. And that's somewhat of a preservative, but it's also theoretically it creates an earthy scent on your trap. And then we're gonna take that trap after it's comes out of the dye solution, and we're gonna dip it in hot melted wax to seal in the dye. But also, we mentioned in the field that wax lubricates the trap, locks in the scent, and also keeps it weatherproof and keeps it from rusting. So multiple purposes of that. But before we do any of that, we've gotta strip that oil off the brand new traps. I don't have any brand new traps with us today. So what we're gonna simulate is we've got some traps from last year that caught some animals in them. They've got various stages of rust, and a lot of the material, our wax and dye, has come off. So we are going to strip these traps down and re-dye and wax them. But it's gonna be in the same process that you would use if you were buying brand new ones. So there's a lot of different ways to do this. The easiest way that I have found is I take a plastic bucket, don't use steel or metal bucket when you're dealing with this product. It's muriatic acid, and you can buy this in any hardware store. It's used for etching concrete or cleaning off brick and mortar. The efflorescence that comes through on brick, this is really common for brick masons to use to clean brick walls. So if you go to the Lowe's or Home Depot or Menards, you can find it either in the paint section, or if you go to the area where they sell mortar and stuff for bricks, you can find it there. It's like $8 for a gallon of this. So I've got rubber gloves on, and I'm gonna put on some eye protection in a second. So you gotta be really careful when you're handling this stuff, because it's very caustic and it will burn your skin and it'll burn your eyes. But we're gonna start out by taking our traps and just setting them down into this bucket of hot water. It's not boiling, it's just right out of the tap, but it's extremely hot. Some people like to add a detergent, like a Dawn dishwashing detergent in there too, and that's fine. It just helps also cut the grease off of the traps. It helps cut through some of the wax. But when you're dealing with this, can you hand me my safety glasses? Peel off the top here. With muriatic acid though, I just start adding it slowly to the water, and you're gonna start seeing a reaction as that acid begins to contact the material around the trap. You'll start seeing some fizzing and bubbling going on. You start seeing that cloudiness as the acid begins to, now you see it starting to come to the surface. It really, it's steaming, obviously, because of also the temperature. We're out in a cool garage, but you'll also have those vapors of the acid coming off the water. And what's going to happen now is it's going to eat that wax and the old dye and stuff off the trap, and it'll begin to float to the surface. So I probably poured a fourth of this, maybe a third of this into that. That's probably about 3.5 or 4 gallons of water. So the point being, you know, we're going to use maybe a half of this for a dozen traps. So $3 or $4 worth of muriatic acid and some hot water. And what we're going to do is let them work in this for an hour or so, kind of see it when it quits bubbling and the stuff quits rising to the surface. There will be a film on the top. So if you can take it outside in a safe spot, gravel driveway is really nice, because that acid will react with the lime in the limestone rock, and it'll neutralize it immediately. But if you don't have some of that, you can pour some baking soda in there until it'll foam like crazy, and then it'll stop. That tells you that it's neutralized. But pouring that water off the top and getting that skim of old grease and wax and whatever the stuff that was on your traps will come off. Get that off before you fish your traps up out of it, because it'll actually coat them again. somewhat when you're taking them out of the water. But we're gonna let those work in there. And while that's happening, we've got our big dye pot over here that we've already pre-mixed up some logwood dye. We've got a bag of this in a pot this size. And we've got the turkey fryer warming this water up. And we're gonna bring that to a really hot temperature where it starts to boil. We're gonna take those traps. One thing that we wanna make a point of showing you though, is you see how this trap has a good bit of surface rust on it. It's not really oxidized yet, but it's just got some of that orange rusty haze on it. That's really what you want your trap to look like after it comes out of that acid bath. If you put it out in the yard, lay it out and rinse it off with water, and if you let it sit there just for a couple hours, it'll immediately start to get a rusty haze on it. That little bit of oxidation right there is great for the dye to adhere to. You'll get a much better dyeing job where it'll stick to the trap and you'll get a better color and a better result if it has a little bit of that rust on it. And it doesn't take long. Once the acid etches that metal and takes all the coatings off of it, you can almost watch it rust before your eyes. If you look in that bucket we still have over here, look at the amount of old wax and grease that's risen to the top of that bucket now. And if I may, I'll pull up a trap just slightly under the surface so you can see it. Look at the bare metal of that trap now. It has eaten every bit of that old wax and dye off that trap. It looks like a brand new piece of steel. Those will take outside, we'll rinse them off, lay them in the grass for a day or two. They'll have that little bit of rust on them, they'll be ready for the dye pot. So this pot has had several traps down in it now for half an hour or so, and you can just check on them periodically, pull them out and see what kind of color they're taking on. This one's getting really good and dark. Again, this is a demonstration. Normally when you're gonna do this, you're gonna wanna have we do dozens of traps at a time. We're doing two or three at a time just to strictly show you how the process works. One thing that we like to do is have the dye and wax going at the same time, because what we're going to do is take the trap out of the dye, we set it down here on the cardboard, we're not going to touch it with our hands, of course it's super hot, but that moisture is going to evaporate quickly because that steel is very, very hot. And Jamie's got the wax over here going and he's heating it up. By the way, we're doing a quick heat job because that wax, there's, I don't know, 5 or 6 pounds in there at least. So what you want to be careful is not to get your wax too hot. And you say, well, you guys have got a big flame going there. We're watching the temperature on it, and as soon as the last little bit of that is melted off, we're going to simmer that or drop that flame way down just enough to keep it in liquid state. Because if that wax burns, it's going to take on a scent of burnt scent, and you definitely don't want that. A safe way to guard against that is to set your wax pot down inside a pot of water, a shallow pan of water underneath it, so you're actually heating the water, which is heating the wax, and it's not a direct flame on that pot that can cause a fire. So what the point being is, this trap is going to evaporate. I'm going to flip it around a couple times, and because the steel is so hot, that moisture will be gone soon, and I'm going to use that hot steel temperature to my advantage going into the wax. Because a common mistake guys make is to dip a trap down in wax and to take it right out. What happens is the trap is a lot cooler than the temperature of that melted wax, and it globs on in a really thick, caked on fashion, and it flakes off really easily, and it really messes up your the function of your trap. You can have too much wax in all the crevices and all the action parts. So what we do is we put the trap down in the wax, and we're gonna do this in just a moment when the rest of that's ready. And you'll see the trap take on a whitish appearance as it submerges into the wax, and you watch it until it becomes clear. As the trap heats up to the temperature of the wax, all the wax that's globbed onto it will melt, and it suddenly looks like your trap is just in water. And at that point, when you don't see any more white coloration on the trap, on any top or bottom, you can flip it over to make sure. As you pull it up out of the trap, or excuse me, out of the wax, let it drip off a few, take it over and set it down on the cardboard and let it dry. Okay, we've given these traps 5 minutes to completely dry up because of the evaporation, the heat of the steel like I was talking about. So we're gonna take this guy, bring him on over here. The trap wax is completely melted now at this point. Drop it down in here, get it completely submerged. And if you don't, if you're not able to wax directly after you die like we are today, and the trap is cold in relationship to that temperature, this is going to take you 3, 4, 5 minutes per trap, maybe tops 2 or 3 minutes. But in this case, because the traps are so hot still, you see how they're coming out of there completely. It just looks like I'm pulling them out of water. There's none of that globbing and white caked on wax like we were talking about. I'll put it back down there one more time. But if your traps are this hot, you can literally just set them in there and pull them right back out. Let that excess drip off. Bring them over here and set them on the cardboard. And by the way, at this point, that trap is completely scent free, no human scent on it whatsoever, and we will not touch that again with our bare hands. I'm using this wire hook on that, but when we get all the traps done, we put on our rubber gloves or our trapping gloves that are scent free. We're gonna take them and we're gonna put them in our plastic buckets or your box, and they should stay in a scent free area. If you put a lid on them, keep them outside or keep them away from solvent smells and things like that in your garage. So this trap, see how nice and dark it came out of that dyeing. That thing is ready to go down in. You'll know immediately if the temperature on your steel is too cold or too cool, because you'll see white buildup on the wax or on the surfaces of the steel immediately. And if your trap pan's not deep enough, you can roll it around to make sure that the wax coats everything. I'm trying to get this guy to flip on its back like that. There we go. But again, this one is done immediately because it's still hot. Pull him right out of there. That is a dyed and waxed coyote trap, ready to go when it cools down.